नमस्कार। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर इन गुड स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ एंड माइंड। आई एम लेफ्टिनेंट डॉक्टर प्रशांत अंबेकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फिजिक्स फ्रॉम धर्मपेट एमपीदेव मेमोरियल साइंस कॉलेज नागपुर इंडिया। फ्रेंड्स, एज वी ऑल नो दैट फोर ऑफ द सेवन डेफिनेशंस ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड्स हैव बीन रिसेंटली अपग्रेडेड इन द 26th एंड 27th सीजीपीएम ड्यूरिंग 2018 एंड 19। हियर सीजीपीएम स्टैंड्स फॉर जनरल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन वेट्स एंड मेजर्स। This presentation is aimed at understanding the upgradation of international standards for physical measurements. I start here with a quote of famous engineer William Thomson, wherein he expressed the importance of quantification in measurements. He said, "I often say that when you can measure what you are speaking about and express it in numbers, you know something about it. But when you cannot express it in numbers, your knowledge is of meager and unsatisfactory kind. It may be the beginning of the knowledge, but you have scarcely in your thoughts advanced to the stage of science, whatever the matter may be." In this presentation, we shall see needs of standards, their background, SI system of units of seven fundamental quantities, and development of their definition. Friends, as you know that upgradation is a continuous process and we need to upgrade ourselves as well as our system, in this case system of units. Measurement is a process of associating numbers with physical quantities and the associated phenomena. Measurement is fundamental to sciences, engineering, construction and other technical fields and to almost all everyday activities. For that reason, the elements, conditions, limitations and theoretical foundations of measurement have been much studied. The physical quantity can be defined as a measurable property of any entity or material. Fundamental physical quantity is defined as a physical quantity which is not dependent on any other for its description or derivation. In metrology, that is the science of measurement, a standard is an object, system or experiment that bears a defined relationship to a unit of measurement of a physical quantity. Or standards are the fundamental reference for a system of weights and measures against which all other measuring devices are compared. The seven fundamental standards are namely second, meter, kilogram, ampere, Kelvin, mole and candela. In order to understand the importance of physical measurements, let us get into the background of it. The building blocks of physics are the physical quantities and the laws of physics are expressed on them. They are divided broadly into two types, fundamental and derived. Based on the nature of quantity, their units of measurements are also defined. Thus, the measurement of fundamental quantities is of great importance. Since ages, there had been many systems in existence for measurement of these quantities, such as foot pound second system, meter kilogram second system, centimeter gram second system, etc. But due to the dissimilarity in their standards, there were huge problems in international affairs. A universal system was indeed needed to bring the entire world into a single set of standards of measurements. The SI system came into existence. SI system of units. The SI is an acronym for a French name, Systeme Internationale des Unites, which defines the seven fundamental units, namely second with symbol small s, meter with symbol small m, kilogram with symbol small kg, ampere with symbol capital A, Kelvin with symbol capital K, mole with symbol MOL and candela with symbol small cd. We shall look into the development of their definitions one by one. Let us begin with unit of time, the second, with a symbol small s. In 1675, unit of time, a second was defined as the fraction 1 divided by 86,400 of the mean solar day. Here, 86,400 is equal to the seconds of a mean solar day consisting of 24 hours, of 60 minutes, of 60 seconds. However, measurements showed that irregularities in the rotation of Earth made this an unsatisfactory definition. If I compare the actual day length, that is sidereal day, that is equivalent to 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds, which consists of 86,164 seconds. If I compare this with the earlier 86,400, it comes 0.997268 51851. It should be exactly unity if the definition is perfect, but it is not coming unity, therefore some error is there, hidden there. Now I must put here one question for you. What is sidereal time or sidereal day? Google it and you will notice the reason of this discrepancy. In 1956, in order to define the unit of time more precisely, the 11th CGPM, which occurred in 1960, adopted a new definition given by the International Astronomical Union based on the tropical year 1900. In this definition, period of one complete tropical year is considered for defining a second. However, it was showing shorter by few nanoseconds as reflected in the calculation here. The tropical year length about 365.24219 multiplied by 24 multiplied by 60 multiplied by 60, that gives you 31556925.216, and if I divide it by the number provided by the definition, that is 31556925.9747, then it comes up with 0.9999995955. That means a error of few nanoseconds is also incorporated in this definition too. Therefore, more precise definition was indeed needed. Experimental work had already shown that an atomic standard of time based on the transition between two energy levels of a molecule or an atom could be realized and reproduced much more accurately. Considering that, a very precise definition of the unit of time was crucial for science and technology. The 13th CGPM, which occurred in 1967-68, chose a new definition of the second, referenced to the frequency of the ground state hyperfine transition in the cesium-133 atom. From this diagram of cesium atom, the hyperfine splitting of the 6s electron level is linked with the frequency 91926317700 Hz, and therefore this particular frequency is taken into consideration to define a new second. It is defined as the duration of 91926317700 periods of the radiation corresponding to the transition between two hyperfine levels of ground state of the cesium-133 atom. And this particular definition is now we are using, which is the exact definition. And you know, this particular transition will never give a false reading. The frequency will not be changed, and therefore our second will not be changed. For more detail, I will suggest you to go to Google and find how the atomic clock works. Friends, as we know that the atomic transitions do not vary with external physical parameters, it produces a perfect definition of a second. Therefore, in resolution 1 of the 26th CGPM 2018,
a revised and more precise wording of the same definition is adopted as a fixed numerical value of unperturbed ground state hyperfine transition frequency of the cesium-133 atom.
Let us see the unit of mass now, the kilogram, with a symbol small kg. Earlier, in 1793, the unit of mass, then called weight, was named as grev, which is equal to the mass of 1 liter of water on its freezing point. But it showed variation as the freezing point changes with little impurities. In 1889, definition of the kilogram was simply the mass of the international prototype, an artifact made of platinum and iridium, which is still kept at the BIPM under the conditions specified by the first CGPM. While sanctioning the prototype, it was declared that this prototype shall henceforth be considered to be the unit of mass everywhere. The third CGPM, in its declaration, brought an end to this ambiguity concerning use of word weight and confirmed that the kilogram is the unit of mass. It is equal to the mass of the international prototype of the kilogram. In the second verification on national prototypes in 1946, it was found that, on average, the masses of the set of original prototypes sanctioned by the first CGPM in 1889 were diverging from that of the international prototype. This was confirmed by the third verification carried out from 1989 to 1991. The median difference was found to be about 25 micrograms. Here you can see the international prototype given in the picture. In order to assure the long-term stability of the unit of mass, to take full advantage of quantum electrical standards and to be useful to modern sciences, a new definition of the kilogram was devised. This definition was based on the value of a fundamental constant, the Planck's constant H. It was chosen and adopted by Resolution 1 of the 26th CGPM, which held in 2018. From this slide, you can see that the kilogram is defined by setting the Planck's constant H exactly to 6.6260715 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Now, this joule can be expressed in terms of kilogram, meter square and second inverse square. Given the definition of the meter and the second here, the formula would be kilogram equals to H upon 6.6260715 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 34 meter square second inverse. Now, in this formula, you see there are two units already existing, one second and meter, which are defined before this unit, and therefore we can use this unit because units are interdependent also. Now, we will see the unit of electric current, the ampere, with a symbol capital A. The CGS electromagnetic unit of current is that current flowing in a 1 cm long arc of a circle of radius 1 cm that creates a field of 1 oersted at the center. A tenth of the electromagnetic CGS unit of current is named as abampere. By the time of the 8th CGPM, which occurred in 1933, there was a unanimous desire to replace the international unit by so-called absolute units. In 1946, the definition of current chosen by the CIPM was referred as the constant current which, if maintained in two straight parallel conductors of infinite length, of negligible cross-sectional area, and placed 1 meter apart in vacuum, would produce a force equal to 2 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 7 newton per meter between them. This was the definition for 1 ampere. It had the effect of fixing the numerical value of the vacuum magnetic permeability mu naught, also called the magnetic constant. But for the realization of this unit,
setup worth measuring the parameters mentioned in the definition was very difficult. This particular absolute unit was not possible with this. Therefore, the present definition based on the fixed numerical value for the elementary charge E was adopted in Resolution 1 of the 26th CGPM, which held in 2018. The definition is as the flow of 1 upon 1.60217 6634 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 times the elementary charge E per second considered as 1 ampere. You can see it from the calculation. There is one question: in order to get some more information about this, is when did the value of vacuum electric permittivity epsilon naught fixed? You Google it and you will enjoy the subject. Now we will see the next unit, the unit of thermodynamic temperature, Kelvin, with a symbol capital K. The centigrade scale is obtained by assigning 0 degree centigrade to the freezing point of water and 100 degree centigrade to the boiling point of water. The definition of the unit of thermodynamic temperature was given by the 10th CGPM, which selected the triple point of water as a fundamental fixed point and assigned it to the temperature 273.16 Kelvin, thereby defining the Kelvin. The 13th CGPM adopted the name Kelvin with a symbol capital K instead of degree Kelvin. However, the practical difficulties in realizing this definition, requiring a sample of pure water of well-defined isotopic composition and the development of new primary methods of thermometry, led to the adoption of new definition of Kelvin based on a fixed numerical value of Boltzmann constant, small k. The present definition, which removed both these constraints, was adopted in Resolution 1 of the 26th CGPM, which held in 2018. The Kelvin is defined by setting the fixed value of the Boltzmann constant to 1.380649 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. Here I have given the scales for comparison, wherein the centigrade scale, then Kelvin scale and Fahrenheit scale are compared here. The next unit, we shall see the unit of amount of substance, the mole, with a symbol MOL. In 1900, stoichiometric quantity, which is the equivalent mass in grams of Avogadro's number of a molecule of a substance, is considered as a unit of substance or amount of substance, a mole. Here stoichiometry means the relationship between the relative quantities of substances taking part in a reaction or forming a compound, typically a ratio of whole integers. For example, H2O gives you twice H plus O. Here H and O are in 2:1 stoichiometric ratio in water. In 1900, the quantity used by chemist to specify the amount of chemical elements or compound is called amount of substance, and this is represented as small n, is defined to be proportional to the number of specified elementary entities, capital N, in a sample, the proportionality constant being a universal constant which is the same for all entities. The proportionality constant is the reciprocal of Avogadro's constant Na, so that you can get this N equals to capital N upon capital N suffix A, this much mole. So the unit of amount of substance is called mole with a symbol MOL. Following the proposals by IUPAP, IUPAC and ISO, the CIPM developed a new definition of mole in 1967 and confirmed it in 1969 by specifying that the molar mass of carbon 12 should be exactly equal to 0.012 kg per mole. This allowed the the amount of substance of any pure sample of entity X to be determined directly from the mass of the sample and its molar mass without the need of or a precise knowledge of Avogadro's number. Thus, this definition of mole was dependent on artifact definition of kilogram. The numerical value of the Avogadro's constant defined in this way was equal to the number of atoms in 12 gram of carbon 12. However, because of recent technological advances, this number is not known with such a precision that a simpler and more universal definition of mole has become possible. This is obtained by specifying the number of entities equal to the Avogadro's constant Na, exactly 6.022140 76 multiplied by 10^23. This has the effect that the new definition of the mole and the value of Avogadro's constant are no longer dependent on the definition of kilogram. The distinction between the fundamentally different quantities, amount of substance and mass is thereby emphasized. The present definition of mole based on the fixed numerical value of Avogadro's constant Na was adopted in resolution 1 of the 26th CGPM 2018. Here I have shown you different materials having 1 mole of their substance. Here mercury, sulfur, sodium chloride, copper, sucrose, etc. are shown here, and you can see every material have different volume of 1 mole of substance. So I hope you have understood the concept of amount of substance with its definition of its unit, a mole. The last unit is unit of luminous intensity, the candela, with a symbol small cd. In 1946, the value of the new candle, early name of for the candela, is such that the brightness of the full radiator at the temperature of solidification of platinum is equals to 60 new candles per square centimeter. You can see it here, the molten platinum is shown here, which is radiating at around 1700 degrees centigrade and above a white light, which is considered as 60 new candles if you take 1 square centimeter portion of the radiation. Before 1948, the unit of luminous intensity were based on flame or incandescent filament standards in use in various countries. These were initially replaced by the name new candle based on the luminance of a Planckian radiator at the temperature of freezing platinum. In 1948, the 9th CGPM adopted a new international name for this unit, the candela, with a symbol small cd. In 1979, because of the difficulties in realizing a Planck radiator at high temperatures and the new possibilities offered by radiometry, that is, the measurement of optical radiation power, the 16th CGPM adopted a new definition of candela, the luminous intensity, in a given direction of a source that emit monochromatic radiation of frequency 5.4×10^14 Hz and that has a radiant intensity in that direction of 1/683 watts per steradian. The present definition adopted in resolution 1 of 26 CGPM, which held in 2018. Now, in 2019, the candela is defined as a unit of luminous intensity in a given direction. It is defined by taking the fixed numerical value of luminous efficacy of a monochromatic radiation of frequency 540×10^12 Hz candela to be 683 when expressed in the unit lumen per watt, which is equals to candela steradian watt inverse or candela steradian per kilogram per square meter second cube, where the kilogram, meter and seconds are defined in terms of Planck's constant h, the velocity of light small c, and the transition of cesium atom delta nu, transition frequency rather. And hence, if you take the ratio of these quantities with 1 or the measured value, if the outcome comes 1, then it will be 1 unit, that is a candela, 1 candela. Friends, at the end of this talk, I am thankful to the Indian Academy of Sciences, Bangalore and National Physical Laboratory, New Delhi for providing me an opportunity to attend the World Meteorology Day celebration on May 20th, 2019, where I got inspired to create this presentation. I would like to thank our principal, Dr. Akhilesh Peshwe, for his constant encouragement and support. Thank you. Your suggestions and queries are always welcome. Jai Hind.